Morning. Welcome to Church of the Ascension on this, the fourth Sunday in Ordinary Time. We are delighted that you're here with us and online. Your presence brings our community great joy. Today's Mass is being streamed live. We are united today in both person and with our online family. The Mass intention for this liturgy are for the deceased Manuel Villarosa and Fidelis Olegario. Eucharistic adoration takes place this Friday, February 5th. In the morning for First Friday, adoration is 1 hour following the 9:15 a.m. Mass. In the evening, adoration will begin again from 4 p.m. to 7 p.m., and it will continue on Friday evenings through the month of February. The Knights of Columbus are offering virtual Living Rosary this Wednesday, February 3rd at 6:30 p.m. on the church's Facebook page. As you consider how Jesus is the authority in your life, we ask for you to also consider prayerfully how you will support the annual diocesan appeal this year coming up in February. You will see some minor changes in receiving Holy Communion and exiting after Mass. Our ushers will no longer guide you through this process. Would you please rise?
Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space our fears and our dreams, brought here to you in the light of this day. Gather us in the lost and forsaken. Gather us in the blind and the lame. Call to us now and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of our name. In the dark of buildings confining, not in some heaven light years away, but here in this place the new light is shining. Now is the kingdom, now is the day. Gather us in and hold us forever. Gather us in and make us your own. Gather in all peoples together.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace, mercy, and peace of God, our loving Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray now. Our sorrow before the Lord. Christ came as one speaking with authority and asking for our love. And so we try to express that in our sorrow. Lord, you have authority over all, over nature, over the law, over everything except your love. Lord, have mercy. Lord, your voice brings us forgiveness. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, truly, you are the source of all joy. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God then have mercy on us all, forgive us our sins, and bring each of us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore. Glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty.
Truth of heart. And we ask this plaintively through our Lord Jesus, your Son, our brother, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, as our one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses spoke to all of the people, saying, "A prophet like me will the Lord your God raise up for you from among your own king. To him you shall listen. This is exactly what you requested of the Lord your God at Horeb on the day of the assembly when you said, 'Let us not again hear the voice of the Lord our God, nor see this great fire anymore, lest we die.' And the Lord said to me, 'This was well said. I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their kin, and will put my words into his mouth. He shall tell them all that I command him. Whoever will not listen to my words, which he speaks in my name, I myself will make him answer for it. But if a prophet presumes to speak in my name, an oracle that I have not commanded him to speak, or speaks in the name of other gods, he shall die.'" The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our response is, if today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us sing joyfully to the Lord. Let us acclaim the rock of our salvation. Let us come into his presence with thanksgiving. Let us joyfully sing psalms to him.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord who made us. For he is our God, and we are the peoples he shepherds, the flock he guides.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
Oh, that today you would hear his voice. Harden not your hearts as at Meribah, as in the day of Massa in the desert, where your fathers tempted me. They tested me, though they had seen my works.
If today you hear his voice, harden not your hearts.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I should like you to be free of anxieties. An unmarried man is anxious about the things of the Lord, how he may please the Lord. But a married man is anxious about the things of the world, how he may please his wife, and he is divided. An unmarried woman or a virgin is anxious about the things of the Lord, so that she may be holy in both body and spirit. A married woman, on the other hand, is anxious about the things of the world, how she may please her husband. I am telling you this for your own benefit, not to impose a restraint upon you, but for the sake of propriety and adherence to the Lord without distraction. The The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
Speak, O Lord,
your servant is listening. You have the words of everlasting life.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Then they came to Capernaum, and on a Sabbath Jesus entered the synagogue and taught. The people were astonished at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority and not as the scribes. In their synagogue was a man with an unclean spirit. He cried out, "What have you to do with us, Jesus of Nazareth? Have you come to destroy us? I know who you are, the Holy One of God." Jesus rebuked him and said, "Quiet, come out of him." The unclean spirit convulsed him, and with a loud cry came out of him. All were amazed and asked one another, "What is this? A new teaching with authority. He commands even unclean spirits, and they obey him." His fame spread everywhere throughout the whole region of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Jim, you do the creed right after this, okay?
The common theme of today's readings is divine authority, as exercised in this world by the prophets of the Old Testament in their messages, by the apostles, including St. Paul, in their writings and teachings in the New Testament, and by Jesus in his teaching and healing ministry. Jesus did not use his authority and divine power to rule and control people, but to set them free. Then we should approach Jesus with our trusting faith so that he may free us from the evil spirits that keep us from praying and prevent us from loving others and sharing our blessings with them. Jesus also frees us from all the evil spirits of fear, jealousy, anger, envy, resentment, and hostility. May God free us from all these spirits, which make us deaf and dumb, blind and lame and paralyzed, physically and spiritually. Jesus used his divine authority to cast out the unclean spirit in the gospel account. So what did St. Mark mean by unclean spirit? Here's a story which might help. A priest had an interesting confrontation with a demon of sorts. He was a chaplain in a large community hospital and was made aware that an 89-year-old man had been admitted to the hospital because of a possible brain injury. The paramedics had found him lying by the steps of his front porch, where he had apparently had an accidental fall. When the priest approached the patient's room, he could hear the man ranting and raving. As the nurse exited the room, she looked at Father and said, "Lots of luck." Noticing the Roman collar beneath the priest's hospital frock, The elderly man immediately went into a trusting plea for help. My children have captured me, have brought me to this place. I don't belong here. They just want my money and my house, and on, with erratic accusations, not giving Father a chance to get a word in edgewise. The better part of wisdom, he thought, was to quietly back out of the room and forget about administering the sacraments. The dispositions just weren't there. Suddenly, however, the priest looked up and said, "Lord, this is supposed to be a sacrament of healing. Then please make it work." Turning toward the old man, he said in a less than reverent voice, "Will you just shut up?" And lo, the man did and was poised to listen. Then the chaplain followed with quiet explanation of the circumstances that brought the man to the hospital, the worry and concern of his family, the likelihood that he would be released quickly. "Now I'd like to anoint you with the healing oil of the sacrament, in which we will pray that the Holy Spirit will heal you in body, mind, and spirit." "Yes, I would like that very much," the man said. After the anointing, the priest said, "Now would you like to receive Holy Communion?" "Why not? I haven't done anything wrong." After communion, the priest and the old man engaged in a very calm and reassuring conversation. And when the priest left, the patient was resting peacefully. The same nurse appeared at the door as the priest was leaving and was amazed. "What did you do?" she asked in wonder. "Just a little magic," the priest said with a twinkle in his eye. The priest's answer may have been a bit humorous because the sacraments are not magic. They are more powerful than magic. They are God working in us. And I have heard from some people and priests that I know, the palpable effect of the sacrament of the sick when it's administered. It's probably the most powerful tool we have with which to deal with the devil, certainly with which to deal with illness. There is, of course, a special rite in the church for exorcising demons, and only the bishop of a diocese can assign a priest to perform this rite, the rite that we saw in the old movie, The Exorcist. Although that movie was full of Hollywood effects, too much to give a true sense of the rite itself. Certainly, non-appointed people should not delve into such things as exorcisms, either alone or with others, and those who do try often get caught up with really undesirable results. So Jesus spoke to the people and to the demons with real authority. Some people recognized it and others refused to. Jesus speaks to us now, all the time. So the question we must ask ourselves is, do we recognize him and his total authority over our lives? When Christian Herder was governor of the state of Massachusetts, he was running hard for a second term in office. One day, after a busy morning chasing votes and no lunch, he arrived at a church barbecue. It was late afternoon, and Herder was famished. As he moved down the serving line, he held out his plate to the woman serving chicken. She put a piece on his plate and turned to the next person in line. "Excuse me," the governor said. "Would you mind if I had another piece of chicken?" "Sorry," the woman said. "I'm supposed to give one piece of chicken to each person." "But I'm starved," the governor said. "Sorry," the woman said to him. "Only one to a customer." Governor Herder was a modest and unassuming man, but he decided this time he'd throw a little weight around. Do you know who I am? I am the governor of this state. Do you know who I am? The woman said. I'm the lady in charge of chicken. Move along, move along. Remember, my friends, that Jesus is the one in charge of chickens and everything else in our lives. So move along, all of us, move along on your journey of life toward his loving presence. Amen.
Please rise and join our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Christ spoke with the voice of God. We, his church, must speak with the voice of Jesus. Let us pray now for its members and for all Christians everywhere.
For the church, Pope Francis, our bishops, priests, and deacons, for their fruitful proclamation of the world, of the word, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For world leaders, all nationally and locally elected leaders, may they work for peace and the common good for all people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parents and teachers of Christian doctrine to guide children in the ways of Jesus, to form their hearts to be models of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask, Father, that you watch over and protect our nation's military and their families. Take into your gracious protection our service members currently deployed. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask Jesus to bring comfort to the homeless and bring healing power on all who are sick, especially Howard Sparks, those suffering from COVID, and for those names we mention aloud now.
Nikki, Melissa, Allison, Brian, Jennifer, Shannon, Chris.
We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We ask you, Father, that you welcome into your kingdom our beloved departed, especially John Hamilton, Maria Paterna, Gibson McNamara, Gregorio Galera, Manuel Villarosa, Fidelis Allegario, and Connie Elfes. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, help us to hear the voice of your Son, so that in our daily living we may be attentive to his loving directives. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. Collection baskets at this time. Thank you for your continued financial support for our parish.
Jim, not yet. Got to do the barakah first, then.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. It is through your goodness that we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made, will be for us the bread of life. Blessed be God. Lord, by this mingling of wine and water, may we be enabled to share his divinity, who humbled himself to share our humanity. And blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. It is through your goodness, too, that we have this wine to offer, the fruit of the vine, yet the work of our hands, it will be for us a spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Lord God, wash away our sins, cleanse us from our iniquity. Pray, my brothers, my sisters, that our sacrifice find favor before God, who is, for each of us, a loving Father. Lord, we bring to your altar these offerings of our service. Be pleased to receive them, we pray, and transform them into the sacrament of our redemption. And we ask this again through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Heavenly Father, Lord of heaven and earth, and through Christ our Lord. For by your word you created the world, and you govern all things in harmony. You gave us that same word made flesh as our mediator, and he has spoken your word to us and called us to follow him. He, then, is the way that leads to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that fills us with gladness. Through your Son, you gather men and women whom you made for the glory of your name into one family, redeemed by the blood of the cross and signed with the seal of the Spirit. Therefore, now and for ages unending, with all of the angels, we proclaim your glory, as in joyful celebration we now acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna.
Holy and to be glorified, O God, you who love the human race and who always walk with us on this journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst when we are gathered by his love, and when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus. For on the day before he was to suffer, on the night of that Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar manner, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and gave you thanks, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me." mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate this memorial of your saving Son's sacrifice for us, your Son whom you led through his passion to death on a cross, and finally to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again. And we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on this oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that, by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whom, whose body and blood we have communion. By our partaking of this mystery, Almighty Father, give us life through your Spirit. Grant that we may be conformed to the image of your Son, and confirm us in the bond of communion, together with Francis, our Pope, and Barry, our Bishop. In fact, the order of bishops, priests, and deacons, your religious, your committed witnesses, however they image the kingdom being unfolded in our midst daily. Grant that the faithful of the church, looking into the signs of the times by the light of their faith, may constantly devote themselves to the service of the gospel, its good news. Keep us attentive, then, to the needs of all, that sharing each other's grief and pain, joy and hope, we may faithfully bring each other the good news of salvation and go forward together along the way of your kingdom. Remember our brothers and sisters who have died, who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone may have known. We mention Manuel and Fidelis now. Admit all to rejoice in the light of your presence, and in the resurrection, give our loved ones the fullness of life. Grant to us, too, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal place with you and live with you forever. There, in communion with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Joseph, her husband, with the apostles and martyrs, with all of your saints, we can only know praise and exalt you in our happiness. And this through Jesus, too. Jesus, your Son, our Savior. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Supreme gift. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant us peace in our day. In your kindness, keep us free from sin. Protect us from every needless anxiety as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the
O Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, my peace I give you, my peace I leave with you. Look not upon our sinfulness, but upon our faithfulness, and grant each one of us the peace, the unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit. Let us share with each other a sign of peace.
This is he who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we to be called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy of you, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Just a moment, if you will, for me to pray as a priest of this mass. Lord Jesus, do not condemn me for my failures, but in your great mercy, through this Eucharist, bring me the fullness of life eternally. Amen. Will you join me now in praying for those who are with us online? Oh Jesus, we believe, all of us, that you are present in the most holy sacrament. We love you above all things and desire to receive you. Since some of us cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, for their behalf we pray, come at least spiritually into our hearts, and come at least spiritually and presently in our hearts as we receive you in our lips. We embrace you, all of us, as if you were already there, and unite ourselves wholly to you. Never permit any of us to be separated from you. Amen. This is the Lamb of God. This is he who takes away the sin of the world. Happy are we to be called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to reach in and out of my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. May the body and the blood of Christ preserve our souls to life everlasting.
Your majesty, you are
declares your majesty. You are
nourished by these redeeming gifts, we pray, Lord, that through this help to eternal salvation, true faith may ever increase. And we pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. If you are a visitor or a newcomer to the parish, Ascension would like to welcome you. In order to do that, I would ask you to stand. Tell us your name and where you're from. Do we have any guests or newcomers? Okay, well, in that case, please remember the social distancing on your way out of church. Please stand for the final blessing.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May you always remember the power of God working through you. May his voice speak in your voice.
Amen.
May his hands work through your hands. May his heart love through your heart.
Amen.
And may he bless you now, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Eucharist is ended.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Testify.